To demonstrate the improved cross-entropy method, let's take a very simple example, trying to estimate the probability that a standard normal variable exceeds a large threshold gamma. We'll find the best important sampling density within the family of normal distributions. I'll just quickly scroll up to show you the import statements that we'll need. And the version numbers of the packages I'm running. It's just SciPy, NumPy, Matplotlib, nothing special. The first step is to sample from the zero variance density G star. Since this is just the distribution of X conditioned on the rare event happening, we can sample lots of X's and just keep those which exceed the threshold. This is called rejection sampling. This will take some time. After simulating 5 by 10 to the 8th samples of X's, we only got 152 samples from G-star. Now we create our important sampling proposal density by finding the maximum likelihood estimates for mu and sigma given these samples. The improved cross-entropy algorithm is now complete, and it has supplied us with a good important sampling proposal distribution. Now we just proceed with a normal important sampling estimation, printing out the probability estimate L hat and the confidence intervals. So our rare event has probability 2.8 by 10 to the minus 7, and our estimate has a confidence interval width in the order of 10 to the minus 10, which is quite impressively small. In the example above, we kind of cheated. Since the rare event was not very rare, we could sample from G-star directly using rejection sampling. In general, this would take too long. One way around this problem is to use the original cross-entropy method. The idea is to construct a sequence of proposal distributions which get better and better, and to stop when we get a proposal distribution which is good enough. Remember, in our notation, the u vector stores the parameters of the original distribution. This was just standard normal, so 0 and 1. And we store the parameters of our various proposal distributions in the v vector. Inside the loop, we start by sampling from our current proposal distribution with v parameters. The threshold for this iteration, gamma I, is set to be the 95% threshold of the x samples. And if this is above our overall goal of gamma, we stop iterating. Otherwise, we pull out the elite x's, which are those which are above our threshold gamma I. On these, we calculate the likelihood ratios between the original distribution with parameter u and the actual distribution with parameter v. Lastly, we update the v parameters to be the maximum likelihood estimates of the elite samples. Don't forget, we must weight the samples by their likelihood ratios. Once CE has finished, we take the proposal distribution it has found and run a normal important sampling estimation. Here we get an estimate of 2.8 by 10 to the minus 7, but our confidence interval width is much wider, on the order of 10 to the minus 8. Let's visualize the sequence of proposal distributions that the CE method constructed. As the CE method ran, we stored the V vectors inside a list named Vs. If we loop through this list, we can calculate the PDF of each proposal distribution over some grid of X values. Note, enumerate is just a nice convenience function in Python, which gives us each element V in our list, as well as its index I. Lastly, we will plot the target distribution G star, since in this very simple case, we do know its normalizing constant L.